Namaskar, I'm Suruchi Das and you're watching Rhythm News. The latest report published by the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom on October 2, 2024 marks another attempt to demonize India and Hindus. This report, which discusses alleged Muslim and Christian persecution in India, is based on questionable data and misinformation. The USCIRF, a federal commission with appointees selected by the US president, has consistently been criticized for meddling in India's internal affairs and reflecting biased views, particularly under the influence of individuals like Seema Hassan, a commissioner of Pakistani origin whose bias against India and Hindus is well documented. The report claims that in 2024, religious minorities in India faced severe violations of religious freedom, including arbitrary arrests of religious leaders, destruction of places of worship, and misinformation campaigns allegedly led by Indian government officials to incite violence. It further criticizes the Indian government's legal framework, particularly the Citizenship Amendment Act, Uniform Civil Code, and anti-conversion laws, suggesting these laws disenfranchise religious minorities. The USCIRF recommends that India be designated as a country of particular concern. One of the primary contentions of the report is its critique of the CAA, a law designed to provide a dignified life to persecuted religious minorities from neighboring countries like Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh. Contrary to the report's claims, the CAA does not affect Indian citizens regardless of their religion. Yet, the USCIRF continues to frame the CAA as discriminatory towards Muslims, neglecting the violent protests by Islamists against the act, such as the anti-Hindu riots in Delhi in February 2020, where over 50 people died and hundreds were injured. These protests, which culminated in riots, were part of a conspiracy to discredit the Indian government during the visit of US President Donald Trump. The violence was fueled by provocative speeches from Islamists like Sharjeel Imam, Umar Khalid, and others who have been implicated in organizing the riots. Despite overwhelming evidence, the USCIRF continues to portray these individuals as victims of religious persecution rather than holding them accountable for inciting violence against Hindus. Additionally, the report criticizes the construction of Ram Temple in Ayodhya, which followed a Supreme Court verdict confirming that the land rightfully belonged to Hindus. The USCIRF falsely claimed that Indian government is deliberately targeting Muslim places of worship, ignoring the fact that many of these structures, including the Babri Masjid, were built on illegally encroached land. The report also dismisses the phenomenon of love jihad, labeling it as a conspiracy theory. However, numerous cases have shown that Islamist men have been using deceitful methods to entrap women of other faiths, including Hindus, force them into conversion and exploit them. This remains a serious concern across several Indian states. India has strongly rejected the USCIRF report, asserting that it is based on a biased and politically motivated agenda. The Ministry of External Affairs formally dismissed the accusations, with spokesperson Randhir Jaiswal emphasizing that the USCIRF has consistently portrayed India in a negative light based on faulty data and a prejudiced narrative. Our views on the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom are well known. It is a biased organization with political agenda, Jaiswal said in response to media queries on Thursday. We reject this malicious report, which only serves to discredit USCIRF further. The MEA also highlighted that the USCIRF has no authority to judge India's internal affairs and that the report undermines India's sovereignty by trying to interfere in its religious and legal matters. The United States, while pointing fingers at countries like India, has its own internal issues that remain largely unaddressed. Religious violence, systemic racism, police brutality, and discrimination against minorities are prevalent concerns within the US. However, instead of introspection, the US continues to interfere in the internal matters of Asian and African nations, using platforms like USCIRF to demonize governments it disagrees with or wants to influence. Reports produced by the USCIRF, including the one targeting India, serves as tools for the US to exert pressure on sovereign nations, undermining their autonomy. Across Asia and Africa, there have been instances where US-backed interventions or reports have destabilized regions, often under the guise of promoting human rights or religious freedom. From intervention in Afghanistan to its notorious involvement in Iraq and Libya, the US has a history of using so-called moralistic stances to advance its geopolitical interests. Many Asian and African countries, like India, have a deep-rooted cultural and religious fabric which the US often fails to understand, choosing instead to impose its own standards of governance and rights. While the USCIRF focuses on criticizing India, the United States itself faces serious issues related to minority groups, religious freedom, and civil rights. African Americans, Hispanics, and Native Americans have long suffered systemic racism, police brutality, and discrimination. The killing of George Floyd in 2020 highlighted ongoing racial injustice. Post 9/11, people of South Asian descent faced heightened Islamophobia, hate crimes, and controversial Muslim ban. Anti-Semitic attacks, including the 2018 Pittsburgh synagogue shooting, have also increased. Native Americans continue to experience poverty and neglect, while rising Christian nationalism fuels violence against religious minorities. These domestic issues expose the hypocrisy of the US in criticizing other nations like India while failing to address its own deep-rooted challenges. Jai Hind.